Hey, Dr. C with you. So when should you test your thyroid? This seems like such a simple question, but what happens is that there's different circumstances, and if they're not taken into account, you're gonna get goofy results. You know, it happens all the time that people get their test results back and they're different than the last ones, and it might not make sense. You know, maybe your scores went up or they went down, and sometimes people will adjust their medication, they'll change their diet, and they don't always see the results they expect. And doctors are often confused about this. They'll see someone whose scores look low, they give them more, and they're still low. So there's a lot of confusion between why thyroid levels change. And the biggest single factor is just that they're not tested in a way that's consistent. So I want to talk about some things to bear in mind. And if you take these simple rules into account as you test your thyroid, it's going to make a whole lot more sense. It's going to be a whole lot easier to get things dialed in, to know what's affecting it, and to help you really feel your best. So first thing to think about is know that it will take 3 months after your last dose adjustment to see your scores level out. Now, I'm not saying you have to wait 3 months, but I'm saying if you test before then, you need to know that you still may drift between when you test and when those 3 months are up. I actually like to test before then just so we can more quickly get someone adjusted and dialed in. But whenever it's less than that time frame, you've got to factor in the fact that it will probably go further. So you're not looking at the end result. And some doctors know how to calculate that, some don't, but you need to know it's not yet at a steady state. Next rule is the time of day. So thyroid hormones, like a lot of things, are on a daily cycle. How much we make at some times is not the same as what we make at others. In a perfect world, we would probably test our levels between like midnight and 3 a.m., but that would involve waking up, the labs aren't open, that would goof some other things up. So yeah, the most practical approach is to test first thing in the morning. And in terms of timing and lab access, it's probably like 7 to 9 a.m. It's not common you can actually access labs and test prior to then. If you tested the same day under the same circumstances, but at a different time, you'll get different levels. So the time of day is critical. And if you're always checking the same time of day, it'll be more consistent. Next one is before taking your thyroid medication. Now, what happens is, after you take a dose of medicine, your blood levels are much higher for T3 and T4 between 1 to 12 hours. Now, between those 1 to 12 hours, you're not always the same amount higher, the same number of hours. It's not consistent. So you can't really take someone and say, let's measure you 4 hours after a dose, and now I can map you in this graph, because there's not a graph, because the same person, if they do that multiple times, won't be at the same place that number of hours afterwards. There are times to where some very advanced doctors will deliberately measure after a dose, not expecting an exact level, but perhaps looking at absorption or conversion or things like that. But in almost all circumstances, the data is much clearer if you take it after you take the medicine, after you take the blood test. So yeah, the day of the blood test, wait till afterward to take your medicine. Next up is fasting. So not doing anything besides water before you take the test, no food, no water. If you have a meal, that can skew your results. The change in blood sugar can change some of your thyroid markers. And we also know that other beverages, coffee, dairy products, these things can also skew your results. So quite simply, think about your blood test as like taking your medicine. Do it before you've had anything, only water, only thing to have before those blood tests. Other consideration would be supplements. And the two big ones here are biotin, but also probiotics. And I don't know, I find an easier rule to say just stop the supplements and stop them for 3 days before your thyroid labs. It turns out that biotin, it doesn't really change the hormones in your body, but it changes the chemistry in ways to where it alters your readings. And then also probiotics, they can change how thyroid antibodies are measured. They can make them look falsely higher. So take a holiday of 3 days of your pills before your thyroid tests. Another rule that can apply for women that menstruate, the time of your menstrual cycle will change your thyroid levels in ways that are rather predictable. So if you're testing between the middle of your cycle, you won't get the same results you would have if you were testing at the beginning of your cycle. The best way to go is to test between days 1 through 9, day 1 being the first day of menstrual flow, or days 21 through 28, but not between days 10 through 20. So 10 through 20, no good. Other times are all fine. If your periods are irregular, wait until the week right when they start. That first week can be a great time because you know when that is. You don't know when it's coming if it's erratic, but you know when it's there. So test during your period if they're irregular. If they are regular, then anytime, days 1 through 9 or 21 through 28. And last up, if you're pregnant, this can cause levels to be erratic. And it can also cause levels to look a little more hyper than normal, and that's actually okay. So it's worth knowing that the ranges are not the same in the pregnant and the non-pregnant state. And it's also worth knowing that a little more bouncing up and down can be expected and can be taken into account. All right, Dr. C here with you. Hope those things were helpful. Some of those things you may not have heard before, but they can make a huge difference. Take great care. We'll see you again soon.